Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you some new things you should check out in macOS Big Sur 11.1. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 800 supporters. Go to macmost.com/Patreon. There, you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So the first major update of macOS Big Sur came out on December 14th. If you haven't updated yet, you can go to System Preferences and then Software Update, and it should come up here. Of course, you have to have already upgraded to Big Sur to get Big Sur 11.1. There are a lot of bug fixes and minor improvements, but here are some things you might want to check out as soon as you update. Now, there are no real changes in the News app, but in the Notification Center, you'll find there are new widgets for news. So go to Edit Widgets, and you'll see there's News now, and you can choose between two different widgets, Today and Topic. Each one has small, medium, and large views. The Topic widget is customizable. You can specify the topic you want. So for instance, let's choose the large one, and I can drag that over to my Notification Center. I'll put it here at the top. And then I can click on it and select the topic. So I click here and I can search for a new topic. So for instance, say I want to track Apple News. I could search for Apple and I could track Apple News or maybe something more specific. Like let's say I want to see news involving Apple Music here. So I select that, click Done, and now you can see I get just that topic represented there. I can always add another one so I can have as many of these as I like, tracking multiple topics as widgets in the Notification Center. Now the TV app has some improvements when it comes to searching and other things. But most notably, there's now an Apple TV Plus tab. So if you're a subscriber to Apple TV Plus, you can get right to the content on Apple TV Plus, which is handy because sometimes you hear about a new show or a movie released by Apple TV Plus, and it's kind of hard to find when mixed in with all the other stuff that you may have going on in the TV app. Now this next one's not actually that big of a deal, but it's going to be talked about a lot, so you should know about it. In the App Store app, you can now go to an app and see privacy information about it. So often you'll select an app like this one. You'll go down in the listing and you'll see app privacy and something like either data not collected or maybe something more specific like data not linked to you. Sometimes though it may look a little scary like data linked to you. You can actually click see details here to get more detailed information. Some people may see this and freak out about what this app is actually doing, but the app I'm looking at here is actually just Pages. And all this stuff makes sense when you think about it. For instance, when you create new documents, there's greater information saved in the metadata, and that includes things from your contacts. When you use the sharing function, of course it's going to access your user ID and things like that to share a file. Just because it's a list here doesn't mean the app is actually taking that information and actually using it for something bad. And just because the app has access to this information doesn't mean it's actually going to use it all the time. For instance, a game may only access this information if you decide to play against a friend online and otherwise may not, but it's still going to be listed here. In the coming days and weeks, a lot of times you're just going to see this, no details provided, because developers haven't yet updated their information there to provide these details. In Safari, there's just one change, but it's an interesting one. If you go to Safari Preferences and then Search, you can now choose a new default search engine, Ecosia. And then when you search for something, it's using the Ecosia search engine. The results you're going to see are actually from Bing, but with some modifications made by Ecosia to try to make the results better. But the revenue on the ads you see on Ecosia are actually going to environmental causes. You can read plenty about that at their site. Apple has promoted Ecosia in various ways before, but now it's officially available as a default search engine on both Mac and on iOS. Now this last new feature I want to show you is, of course, only available on the new M1 Macs. And that's because it involves actually running iOS and iPadOS apps on your Mac, which is only available on the new Apple Silicon Macs. And this is much improved Windows sizing options. Apps tend to look better now. I've seen that already in a few apps. Plus you can click the green button now to go full screen in most iPhone and iPad apps, which makes many apps far more usable, including some of my own games that look great when brought to full screen on your Mac. If you want to see the full list of everything that's new in macOS 11.1, you can go to this webpage. This is the same list you're given when you first update to 11.1. And there's one other detail that's easy to overlook in all of this, and that's the version number here. It's 11.1, which means all of the updates for macOS Big Sur, macOS version 11, are going to be .1, .2, .3 updates. So next year's macOS will most likely be version 12. So after more than a decade of macOS being macOS version 10 and then 10.1, 10.2, 10.3, each being major annual updates, it looks like Apple has now switched to the number being the annual update. So Big Sur is version 11. Next year we'll have version 12, 13, 14. This is now in line with the other operating systems like iOS, where the primary number is increased with every new version. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.